First off, we're in an amazing place at an amazing time. You know, technology is like the tide. It never stops, and every wave that hits the shore brings some sort of an opportunity.
The automation we see today allows you access to your if-only list.
It's going to change the dynamics of everything we do.
Like, you probably not that long ago bought a phone based on the fact, ooh, it has 256 gigabytes of storage. You won't even think about things like that in the future. It's an irrelevant metric, just like you don't think about water in the context of its denominations. Imagine when that's the reality around data and around intelligence being applied to data, so that every data bit that's shaping a workflow inside of an enterprise is perfectly informed. It changes everything. It changes the fundamental essence of an enterprise. And this is the journey that every business is on over the next decade. And it's not a question of if, it's not a question of whether you can put your head in the ground and just wait for it all to happen. I think in the next decade, the companies that don't transition will go away. They'll be part of an artifact of the past. And those who build modern workflows, leveraging AI, ML, all of the data repositories of society will lead the world moving forward.
Most companies have a technology stack today of about 1,500 to 3,000 different applications that they use. The fact that you need a bot to help automate some of that process, some of the processes that are between applications, is a game changer. The other aspect of technology that is changing is the merger of robotic process automation, and or core automation as we call it, with artificial intelligence and intelligent automation, and creating a robust platform by which the problems that we are solving through automation are much more complex and much more far-reaching. And so that's where I see robotic process automation becoming even more human-centric in the next few years. The fact that I could use analysis or actionable insights or use artificial intelligence and machine learning to create better decision making for the human that is using the bots is a game changer. I do believe the benefits of automation and robotic process automation in particular will be felt by society in a number of different ways. Think of the insurance company that is able to process a claim for fire insurance for a home, for somebody who lost their home in the fire, in a week or few days versus 3 months or 6 months is a game changer for that person and the society there. Think of the person who's waiting on cancer results from a blood test and doesn't have to wait 2 weeks for that result, not for a pathologist to actually look at the results and give a skilled opinion on it or an experienced opinion on it, but for the application of that data into three different systems or getting that data verified again by three different systems. This will change the way society operates on multiple levels in many, many industries for the better and for the better of our experiences as a society.
I'm now starting my fourth decade in the technology industry. In the 80s, we brought personal computing to the world. I think to the 90s, I had the great fortune of being with a company that shaped the networking industry. Turn the clock forward to the beginning of the new century. The cloud emerged. It brought unlimited processing power, the ability to scale at any moment to the most, to the highest requirements of compute, networking, and storage. Now turn the clock forward to the decade we're in right now and the promise of the decade ahead. It's all about automation. The automation frontier in front of us is breathtaking.
RPA will have an ability to liberate those people from doing repetitive things that we all do every single day. And in fact, we become so used to it, we don't even know that we do it half the time. But once you understand that there are so many things that we do as employees that could be automated, just imagine what you could do with the rest of that time to actually do what human beings are really good at, which is being creative, being collaborative, and actually coming up with things that technology can never do, and that's coming up with really interesting ideas.